Quai des Polars.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
He is a physician in a small town, and the doctors in small towns tend to do everything. They do surgery as well as just family care and delivering babies. And generally my novels start with several independent things coming together and sort of colliding until they become substantial enough that I realize I have a novel. And one of the first ideas I had was of having this observer of everything that went on in a city. And as I thought about it, I realized, well, a doctor would be perfect for that, because they really do. These doctors have delivered the children that they take care of their entire lives. And so I use that. And part of them is autobiographical, but I worked in healthcare for about 25 years off and on. I was a respiratory therapist taking care of mainly newborn babies. So parts of Lamar are cobbled together from doctors I worked with, nurses that I worked with, and various other people. So he's a real amalgam. One of the major themes of the book is empathy, is the ability to actually feel what other people feel, or to try, get as close as we can, and to see the world the way these other people see it. And that's, of course, as you say, precisely what a writer does or tries to do. And you can see Lamar doing that from the very first, when he goes, a woman has canceled her surgery, and he goes to talk to her very early in the book. And you can see the way he acts, that he does have great feeling for that woman and her station in life, and is fascinated by the story she tells him about her when she was younger. And you don't know why he has that empathy until later on in the book, when you find out about his traumatic incident, which, you know, not only made him a doctor, but it probably gave him a lot of that empathy that he has now. And since his father was a writer, it's kind of fun to play with that that sort of toss off between the doctor with his empathy and the writer with a different kind of empathy. Yes, you're right. It did come from Bartleby the Scrivener, Melville's short story. As I was thinking what to name the town, I think that Bartleby is a keystone story in American literature that I prefer not to. But with Will Not, of course, it's gone from I prefer not to, a very mild negation, to I will not do it, which I think is kind of what's happened with a lot of us who have felt that we're apart from the mainstream. And the origin of Will Not, of the city, is I was thinking, and this is one of those other things that began to congeal, I was thinking about all of the utopian colonies that started in the United States in the 1800s, and there were dozens and dozens of these. This is when the Amish started the Amana colonies. We had the Transcendentalists starting Brooks Farm and Fruitland. We had the Oneida community, which was communist in inspiration. Dozens of these. And thinking about those in terms of the communes in the 60s, when young people decided to withdraw from the society as a large and make a smaller society. So I was wondering what would happen if this sort of thing persisted into present time. And that was the idea. And you see that idea when you get the background of Will Not. And Will Not obviously isn't where it was then, but there's a certain contrarianism that keeps going with Will Not. These are people who do not want to be part of the large community. And they don't have to there. And there's the sheriff at one point says, you know, we've got a lot of strange people here. We seem to attract them. And Lamar says, well, look at our history. And that's the point you begin to find out what really happened here. What is this place? I came from a small town, and I had always written about cities, and I decided that I really wanted to write about a small town. And It's a small town in the South, and we were contrarians. Everyone was very much a cowboy and lived his own life and left other people alone. And I wanted to do that. And it's when I got this idea for Will Not that I thought, I finally have my vehicle. I have my way of writing about a small town. And I really, really enjoyed doing it. Well, I really wanted to talk about people creating their own communities and how communities come about and how you govern communities and how communities stay together even through a lot of stress and trauma. So I really kind of pile things on with this story. It begins with the discovery of a pit full of bodies, basically, out at an old gravel quarry. And if it were a standard crime novel or a mystery, you would assume that we would find out where those bodies came from. And we actually don't. We get some fantastical stories about where they could have come from. And then other things show up after that. A boy who was in a coma, very much like Lamar's own, that Lamar took care of as a doctor, shows up. And he's an ex-Marine. He may be AWOL. He may be away without leave. He's obviously been hurt. Something's going on. So that becomes a secondary strain. And you just kind of keep going from there. But it's mostly about Lamar, about his city, his relationship to different people in the city at every level, and his relationship with his partner, who is male. And that's another sign of how Will Not lets people be themselves, that everybody accepts it completely with no question. And when I first started writing, Lamar was going to have a female partner, and it didn't work. And I kept trying to rewrite it, and it still wouldn't work. So one day it occurred to me, well, you know, the way these things do, well, of course, it's not female. His partner is male. And the minute I got that, so much of the story started falling together. Making him a teacher, I had so many opportunities to talk about young people and to talk about the history of the city or the town. And that was sort of the last piece when I really realized that they were a homosexual couple and a very happy, very pleasant homosexual company who, again, allowed each other to have his own life and didn't try to intrude upon that in any way. My favorite single novel is Camus L'Étranger, which I read, was my first novel I read in French, and it's a novel that I teach and that I talk about all the time. There's a science fiction writer named Theodore Sturgeon, who I personally think is one of the finest writers who ever lived, and he's mentioned in Will Not a few times, but I continue to go back and read his stories and his novels over and over. And he was one of the writers who convinced me that I could do this and that I really needed to do this. So I go back there. I enjoy Mark Twain a great deal, and I love James Joyce, especially the short stories in Ulysses. I kind of cut off after that. It gets a little too esoteric for me. But I've taught those and really enjoy those as well. But I do read an awful lot. For years, I reviewed books, and I had books coming by the crate almost into the house. So I do read quite a lot. The only reviewing I'm doing now is mainly for the magazine of fantasy and science fiction. So I read a lot of fantasy and a lot of science fiction, and there's some exciting, exciting work being done in that now. It's a writer named Keish Johnson, who is just extraordinary, but many others too.